I shut away inside of myself the power that caused Alfin to lose control. Since then, my visions of the future have grown more and more fearsome.
Is this another memory? No, it's different this time. It's like she's speaking directly to us.
What we did back then. Not so much as a day passes when I don't think about it. About what was done to us. All in the name of a ceremony. The purpose of which we were never even told. As Sovereign, they linked Alfin's consciousness to Lenegus itself. The Renus Alma was intended to control his power, lest anything should slip through its... cracks. That day, as Maiden, my role was to temper his power. I was meant to guide it forth, and give shape to the strength inside of him.
Linked to Lenegus itself? But then, everything that's been happening...
But that power showed me a vision. A vision of oblivion. When I realized that vision was a prophecy of the apocalypse we were about to unleash, I couldn't go through with it. But without a maiden, the ceremony was doomed. Alfin lashed out, his consciousness no longer his own. I did what I could. Using my abilities as the maiden, I tried to seal that power away inside of me. But it was too late. Lenegus had already been brought to its knees. Thousands upon thousands of lives so cruelly snuffed out. All because of me. Because of what I had done. With the destructive force now slumbering inside of me, I knew I had to find a way to dispose of it. Anything to make up for my failure. But I didn't know how. Especially since that power was astral energy itself. In which case, ironically enough, the Renus Alma seemed to be my best bet. That, at least, would hold the astral energy dormant. Assuming that no malevolent third party got to it first. With the Sovereign and Maiden's combined power, perhaps I could shift the chaotic energy inside me into the Renus Alma instead. That's what I hoped, but alas, it was not to be. The Renus Alma was lost, and Alfin the Sovereign was in a starship bound for Dana. My only choice was to seal away the destructive force inside of me using my powers as the Maiden, to buy the world what little time I could. The time needed for a new Renus Alma to be crafted, and for a new Sovereign to appear. Even if by doing so, it meant I would be passing the curse onto my descendants as well. Please, forgive me. I never meant to burden the future world with this threat, too. I only wish that there was something more I could have done.
Wait, you can't just...
Naori.
That message just now, was it directly from Naori? Or was it the Danann voice speaking through her?
What?
These are the clothes that Naori and I wore during the ceremony 3 centuries ago.
So you're saying this is the Maiden's outfit?
That's right. These clothes are designed to resonate with the Sovereign and Maiden's abilities. They focus and enhance them.
And they appeared now because...
Naori must have left them here for the new Sovereign and Maiden, knowing the day would come when they would need them in their fight against the Thorns.
These outfits are directly linked to the answers we've been chasing this whole time. If they're here, it must mean it was Naori's will for us to find those answers as well.
Locating the Renis Alma would allow us to neutralize the dark astral energy inside Xion, thereby silencing her thorns. Is that what Naori's suggesting?
It makes sense. After all, Master Cores and Spirit Vessels are both able to prevent the astral energy inside them from developing sentience. By that logic, it would stand to reason that the Renis Alma would have the same ability on a larger scale.
We have a Maiden and Sovereign. Now all we need is the Renis Alma, and we'll finally be able to free you of your thorns. Xion.
It's possible? You really think so?
I do. We can rid you of your thorns and stop the world from falling to oblivion.
However, the spirit channeling ceremony already failed once. Even if our goal is different this time, we can't be sure the same thing won't happen again. We should take care not to be too optimistic.
You're right. It's the barest sliver of a chance. But if there's even the slightest hope it can work, I'm willing to stake everything I've got on it.
I know it's too early to let myself feel relieved, but I just can't seem to help it. Just hearing there's the slightest chance, even though I know the world's still in great peril, it's selfish of me, I know, but still.
No, it isn't! You found hope to believe in. It'd be strange if you weren't over the moon about it.
Rinwell's right. We can rid you of your curse and still save the world at the same time.
Thank you. Naori entrusted us with the fate of all humanity. Now, it's up to us to prove that trust was well placed.
Starting with a little game called Hunt the Renis Alma.
Yeah, we've come all this way. Now we just need to search Lenegas and Rena until we find it.
Yeah, we can protect the world and save Xion at the same time.
I too shall lend my services. My knowledge of Renan lore is bound to be a useful asset.
And they say modesty is dead.
Miracles just seem to follow wherever you go, huh?
How do you know it's me they're following? We're all in this together, Xion. You included. Now let's get moving, shall we? Last I heard, we had an apocalypse to stop.